Marc-Uwe Kling und Bruno das Biest. Bruno the Beast.
Ja, Boris the Beast heißt der junge Mann.
Wo seid ihr?
Tja, deswegen habe ich ihn dabei.
I have to sing with
und
me.
Natürlich auch, weil Boris gleichzeitig Security macht.
Boris has to do security.
Ja, ich herzlich willkommen. Ich habe mir einen Plan gemacht. Ich habe eine Stunde
a
Zeit.
Plan.
Das ist deswegen habe ich mir dieses technische Wunderwerk gekauft.
This is why I bought this technical wonder thing.
Es ist eine Uhr.
Es hat clock.
Voll die krasse Akkulaufzeit.
Crazy battery
gut.
Life.
Ja, ich, also als Vorbereitung habe ich einfach mal meinen Computer durchsucht auf alle meine Texte, in denen das Wort Computer
I looked through all my texts where the word computer is in.
Und es war viel zu viel, vor allem war es das komplette neue Buch. Das hat also nichts gebracht.
It didn't bring me much.
Deswegen mache ich jetzt, ich mache einfach
nicht. That's why, who cares?
Und, aber es ist ein bisschen, ich habe ein bisschen Angst. Also ich habe also ein Buch über.
A bit afraid.
Ja, es spielt eigentlich geht es um die Zukunft. Es geht nur aus Versehen um Technik, weil die Technik doch irgendwie einen Einfluss auf die Zukunft hat. Aber eigentlich wollte ich nur ein Buch über die Zukunft schreiben.
Doesn't have much influence on the future.
Und jetzt habe ich aber ein bisschen, ist es wie vor. Wenn man als Popmusiker vor einem Haufen Jazzmusikern auftreten würde. So, das ist mein Gefühl.
I didn't get that. We have technical problems, I'm sorry to say.
Dabei habe ich auch mal programmiert, ja? Nämlich mit Turbo Pascal 5.
But I did program myself with Turbo Pascal 5.
Unter DOS, genau, als dann so und Windows 3.11, da bin ich dann ausgestiegen, das war mir zu kommerziell, aber ich habe es vorhin erzählt, ich habe mit 12 oder so ein Programm geschrieben, das mit dem man die Spielstände für UFO, Enemy Unknown, cheaten konnte, also
with which I could cheat in UFO, Enemy Unknown.
Hat irgendein Spielemagazin geschickt und es war dann auf der CD und als Shareware und ich war so stolz und man konnte für 5 Euro die Vollversion bestellen, wo man dann nicht nur das Geld, sondern auch noch was weiß ich, was anderes verändern konnte und ich habe einen Brief bekommen, von jemand, der das bestellen wollte. Es war offensichtlich jemand, der noch jünger war, ein kleines Kind. Und es war alles voller Rechtschreibfehler. Und es waren 5 D-Mark-Scheine in dem Briefumschlag und keine Adresse drauf.
Yeah, trying to listen to the stage sound, but I,
das beschäftigt mich bis heute. Falls dieser jemand hier
really
unter euch
maybe catch
sein
anything.
Sollte,
sorry.
Dann, es war nicht meine Schuld. Ich wollte es, die Diskette, das war damals noch der Distributionsweg der Wahl.
Distribution way of the
world. Nicht, war keine
everybody
Ahnung,
used.
War. Gut.
And good.
Also Turbo Pascal.
Turbo Pascal.
Dann als Vorbereitung für das Buch habe ich einen Freund
for the book,
von mir, der heute programmiert, gebeten, mir nochmal zu zeigen, was man heute so
show
programmiert.
Me what you are programming today.
Was macht man heute so? Wir haben also eine App
today?
Geschrieben.
And we did a app together.
Eine App, die, also es ist die erste sinnvolle App in
sensible
meinen
app.
Augen. Eine App, die Zitate falsch
that,
zuordnet.
Also puts,
ihr kennt vielleicht das Konzept. Man,
quotes to the wrong
man nimmt
person.
Ein Zitat, dann schiebt man eine falsche Quelle drunter,
and
einen falschen
Autor.
Und dann
source.
Kann man das so Tinder-mäßig nach
you can like nicht Tinder, like swipe it also to funny or
Tinder,
unfunny.
I'm not von
funny at Tinder, but it's like the function of Tinder.
Oder nicht witzig wischen.
You see something, you can like swipe it to funny or not funny.
Gut, ich bin bei Tinder.
So, yeah. I'm so at Tinder, so
habe ich Boris kennengelernt.
I learned Boris that way.
Ich habe ihn gesehen und habe witzig gewischt und
I swiped
Boris
too funny.
Verwischt.
Boris just misswiped.
So sind wir zusammengekommen.
And so we got together.
Na jedenfalls.
Anyway,
diese App merkt sich,
app
was man witzig
remembers
fand und
what you
schlägt dann halt
find funny
andere witzige
and
Kombinationen vor.
Like gives you more funny.
Ich lese mal ein paar vor. Das ist jetzt
like
nicht von mir.
It's not from
me. Experiment in Maschinenhumor.
Machine
also
humor.
Was finden Maschinen lustig?
What do machines find funny?
Erzähle nicht die Wahrheit, solange dir etwas Interessanteres einfällt.
If you can't say something more interesting. Mark Zuckerberg.
68% witzig.
68% funny.
Im Prinzip geht es darum, als erster Feierabend zu machen.
The only principle
Artikel 1
is
des Grundgesetzes.
To be the first one to be able to go into the free time. Article 1 of the Grundgesetz, the basic rights of Germany.
Wohlstand ist, wenn man mit Geld, das man nicht hat, Dinge kauft, die man nicht braucht, um
wealth
damit Leute zu beeindrucken,
is if you
die
can
man
buy,
nicht mag.
Apple. Things with money you don't have to impress people you don't like. Apple.
Im Grunde, wenn man das auf das Wesentliche
basically
reduziert, bin ich ein erwachsener Mann, der
I'm
Make-up
adult
benutzt.
Man who uses
der
Make-up.
Joker.
The Joker.
Digital first, Bedenken second,
Digital first,
Big Brother.
Bedenken,
hey, hey, hey,
wearing second,
Alex,
Big Brother.
Vorhang auf für seine
hey, hey,
Horror-Show.
Here comes Alex.
Alexander Gauland.
Open the curtains for his horror show. Alexander Gauland, chef of the right-wing party in Germany.
Gut, also ich lese euch was aus dem Buch vor.
I read from the book.
Das habe ich schon erwähnt. Ich habe hier,
about before,
das finde ich besonders witzig, eigentlich ein Impressum. Was reingeschmuggelt? Technischer Hinweis.
Technical note.
Dieses Buch kann sich nicht mit dem Internet verbinden.
Internet enabled.
Trotzdem
you can,
du
however, still add comments to it.
Diese wird
but it's
aber
very unlikely that anyone will read them.
Du kannst
you can share this book,
teilen. Allerdings
but not
nicht
with all your friends of
ons. Wenn du das
if you do share it, of course, it's possible that someone will read your comments after all and perhaps even comment on your comments.
Den
in order to change or update the contents of this book, the publisher would need to hire someone to break into her house at night, creep over to her bookcase and cross out or edit sentences with a felt tip pen or biro. That's possible,
möglich,
but unlikely.
So, in dem Buch
in the book,
Werbung aus
there's
der Zukunft,
advertisement from the future,
Nachrichten,
news,
damit man beim Lesen nichts verpasst,
so you know what's happening.
Werbung in den Nachrichten,
advertising in the news,
Reiseführerbeiträge und da das ein bisschen verwirrend
like
ist,
travel guides,
Boris sich in mühevoller Heimarbeit
much, Boris
wunderschöne Jingles ausgedacht,
made up some
die
jingles
euch ein bisschen Orientierung geben sollen.
To give you orientation.
Dazu müsste erstmal mein Bass wieder an sein.
Just have to put on my bass again, my bass.
Ah, danke. Ah. Quality Land, dein persönlicher Reiseführer.
Quality Land, your personal travel guide.
Einführung. Da du dich in Quality Land noch nicht auskennst,
as you don't know
how
your way around Quality Land, we've put together a brief introduction for you.
2 Jahre
two years before Quality Land was founded, or in other words, 2 years
time,
before Quality Time, there was an economic crisis of such severity that this became known as the crisis of the century.
Es war
it was the third crisis of the century within just a decade. Swept
von der Panik
along
der
by the panic of the financial markets, the government turned to the business consultants from Big Business Consulting,
BBC,
for help.
Und diese
we decided
Land
that what the country needed most was a new name.
Der alte
the old one was worn out and, according to surveys, only inspired diehard nationalists with minimal buying power.
Außerdem
not to mention the fact that the renaming would also divest the country of a few unpleasant historical responsibilities
so
in the process.
The
past army had been known to, well, let's just say, they overshot the mark a little.
Hinausgeschossen. Die Unternehmensberatung
firm commissioned the creatives at the advertising agency Worldwide Wholesale WWW to come up with a new name for a country as well as a new image, new icons and a new culture.
Kurz gesagt,
in short, a new country identity. After a considerable amount of time and even more money, after suggestions and counter-suggestions, everyone involved finally agreed upon the now world-famous name Quality Land. Can you imagine any name more perfectly suited for appearing after Made In on products? Quality Land. Even Quality Land's inhabitants were renamed. They couldn't just be ordinary people after all, they had to be quality people. Their surnames in particular sounded very medieval and didn't fit with the new progress-oriented country identity. A land of Millers, Smiths and Taylors isn't exactly a high-tech investor's wet dream. And so the advertising agency decided that, from that moment on, every boy would be given his father's occupation as a surname and every girl the occupation of her mother. The deciding factor would be the job held at the time of conception.
We wish you an unforgettable stay in the land of Sabrina Mechatronics Engineer and Jason Kleiner,
the most popular middle-class rap duo of the decade. The land of Melissa Prisoner and her twin brother Kevin Warden, the undefeated battlebot jockeys of the century. The land of Henrik Engineer, the richest person in the world. Welcome to the land of the superlative. Welcome to Quality Land.
Henrik Ingenieur, dem reichsten Menschen der Welt. Willkommen im Land der Superlative. Willkommen in Quality Land.
Ja, so.
Das irritiert mich total krass, wenn ich mich da sehe.
Irritated by
das ist, wow, guck mal, meine Augen. Das ist echt eyes. Heftig. Sollte mal wo auftreten, da hatten die... Oh Gott, das ist ja noch viel schlimmer.
The planks.
Hallo Marc-Uwe, hallo. Hallo Boris.
Du musst in die Richtung winken.
Ja, ich, das ist ja wie Nordkorea hier. Also,
feels like North Korea.
Gut. Ich versuche das. Ich lese das Kapitel einfach vor und ich halte das Buch so. Das Kapitel heißt Vorstellungsgespräch. Es ist ein kalter, unpersönlicher Raum, aber immerhin ist er durch eine Glaswand von den 126 anderen Menschen abgetrennt, die in einem großen Saal an genormten Tischen hocken. 64 von ihnen telefonieren, 32 arbeiten an Computern. Alle bis auf 16 schieben sich hastig Essen in den Mund. Es ist Mittagszeit. Peter gegenüber, an der anderen Seite des Tisches, sitzt eine junge Frau. Sie heißt Melissa. Mehr verrät ihr Namens-Call-out nicht. Vor ihr liegt ein Quality-Pad, auf dem sie sich Notizen macht. Erzählen Sie mir etwas über sich, sagt Melissa und zupft an ihrem Business-Kostüm herum. Tja, also eigentlich steht alles in meinem Profil, sagt Peter. Ich lese mir die Profile der Bewerber nie durch, sagt Melissa. Sonst hätte ich ja gar kein Gesprächsthema mehr. Okay, ich heiße Peter. Nachname? Arbeitsloser? Verstehe. Was verstehen Sie? Genug. Level? 10, lügt Peter. Aktueller Beruf? Ich bin Maschinenverschrotter. Allerdings ist das eine Tätigkeit, die mich nicht gerade mit Leidenschaft erfüllt. Verständlich. Darum könnte ich mir gut vorstellen, in Zukunft etwas anderes zu arbeiten. Haben Sie irgendwelche Ausbildungen? Sagt die Frau. Zusatzqualifikationen? Ich habe eine Ausbildung zum Maschinentherapeuten angefangen. Ist das nicht verboten? Jetzt schon, sagt Peter, aber als ich mit der Schule... Sie meinen Ausbildung Stufe 2? Ja, als ich mit Stufe 2 fertig war, schien Maschinentherapeut ein Beruf mit Zukunft zu sein. Tatsächlich? Für mich klingt es nach esoterischem Unsinn. Was gibt es an Maschinen zu therapieren? Eine Maschine funktioniert oder sie funktioniert nicht? Naja, sagt Peter. Die meisten Leute glauben immer noch, dass künstliche Intelligenzen von Menschen programmiert werden. Aber das stimmt nicht. Moderne Maschinen werden angetrieben von selbstlernenden Algorithmen, die dadurch schlauer werden, dass sie unsere Daten, unsere Gespräche, Mails, Fotos und Videos analysieren.
Es ist wohl unvermeidlich, dass einige davon psychische Probleme bekommen. Gemobbte Drucker.
As a result, it's probably
großrechner mit Burnout.
Some of them get psychological
digitale Übersetzer
problems.
Mit Tourette.
Mob printers, mainframe computers
elektronische Haushaltshilfen mit zwanghafter Persönlichkeitsstörung. Ich hatte aber die Ausbildung noch nicht abgeschlossen, da wurde das Therapieren von Maschinen leider verboten. Disorder. Warum?
But before I could finish my training, machine therapy was banned.
Ja, sagt why? Peter. Das Therapieren wurde als eine Art Reparatur angesehen und Sie wissen ja, wie der Kinderreim geht. Neues kaufen, das ist recht, reparieren, das ist schlecht. Und anstatt Maschinentherapeut zu werden, wurden Sie Maschinenverschrotter. Peter zuckt mit den Achseln.
So becoming a machine
ich habe nichts gefunden und als mein Großvater gestorben ist, hat mir das Ministerium für Produktivität gesagt, ich solle seinen Laden der Schrottpresse übernehmen. Meine Sachbearbeiterin meinte, ich solle froh sein, denn ich hätte doch irgendwas mit Maschinen machen wollen.
He smiles. My caseworker told me I should be happy, given that I said I want to do something with machines.
Ich muss gestehen, die Frage hat etwas deprimierendes.
When do you see yourself in 5 years?
Was würden Sie sagen? Sind Ihre Stärken, Ihre Schwächen?
No idea.
Jetzt muss Peter doch
lachen. Honest, I find the question
können Sie mir
kind of depressing.
Sagen, was so witzig ist? Fragt die junge Frau. Ich amüsiere mich auch
say
gern.
Your strengths and weaknesses are.
Sagt Peter.
No, Peter can't help but laugh.
Und muss gegen seinen
Would
Willen noch lauter
me
lachen.
So funny? Asked the
Melissa
young woman.
Verzieht ihr Gesicht.
I like
bin
a good
lächerlich
too.
Für Sie?
Peter I doubt that,
nein,
says Peter,
nur nothing daran even louder denken, dass ich vor Jahren mal ein Bewerbungsgespräch hatte, frowns. Dass ich wie ein Rendezvous
am I amusing you?
Jetzt habe ich ein Peter Rendezvous, pulls himself together. Wie ein Bewerbungsgespräch
no,
it's anfühlt.
Just occurred to me that some years ago I had an interview
wollen wir uns nicht wenigstens duzen?
That felt like a date and
Melissa
now I'm having a date that feels like an interview.
Dann seine Bitte durch eine herablassende Geste. Kurz
Melissa shrugs
Peter
for a moment. Peter regrets having activated the quality partner voucher.
Dann kommt glücklicherweise der Kellner mit dem
luckily the waiter comes over to their booth with the food, putting an end to the uncomfortable
Peter,
silence.
Ist dir schon aufgefallen, dass wir Once beide fast gone, die einzigen Peter in diesem Restaurant sind, die nicht arbeiten?
Have you noticed that we are almost the only
dich,
one in the restaurant
Melissa.
Not working?
Ich arbeite konstant an mir selbst.
Speak for yourself, says Melissa.
Na,
I'm constantly
jedenfalls hatte ich mich während der Ausbildungsstufe 3 als Aushilfe
well, anyway, I once applied for an intern position at a startup during education level 3. There was a government program which subsidized 6-month positions for people with my surname, jobs for the jobless. I can still remember the interview as if it was yesterday. There was soul music coming from the loudspeaker, freshly baked homemade
ich liebe, was die Firma tut.
The human resources manager phoned up my coffee mug and then sat down very close to me on the couch. I said a few times how much I loved what the company was doing and I thought its products were amazing. The HR woman told me how important I was to the company as a human. We spent the rest of the time just talking about films, music and hobbies. We talked shop about the virtual reality remake of Lord of the Rings. For example, both of us had thrown up during the giant eagle flight sequence. Every time I said something she found funny, she gave me a playful nudge on the shoulder. When I was signed in the contract, she cried, saying it was such an emotional moment for her.
Peter schiebt sich ein paar Nudeln in den Mund. Ich habe nie wieder von ihr gehört.
It was okay to cry, she said.
Melissa hat sich während
when she let me go 6 months later, it said in the dismissal letter that it wasn't me, but her. And that she hoped we should stay friends.
Und ich verschwende ungern meine Zeit.
Peter shoved a few noodles in his mouth. I never heard from her again.
Was verstehst du?
Melissa's expression had remained unchanged during Peter's story.
Also, sagt Melissa,
my name is Melissa Sex Worker, she says. I come from the very bottom and I want to make it all the way to the top. And I don't like wasting my time.
Warum hat dich deine vorherige Partnerin verlassen? Wieso denkst du,
what
dass ich verlassen
see?
Worden bin? Vielleicht habe ich selber Schluss gemacht.
So, Melissa, says Melissa, how long have you been alone? Analog. What's analog?
Wir
a single person. That's what it's called
was
now.
Du denn
oh, well, not that long.
Kommentare. Für die Nachrichten? Fragt Peter, du bist Journalistin? Nein.
Why don't we change the subject, Peter sighs.
Videos,
what do you do for work?
Du bist ein Troll?
I write commentaries. For the news, asked Peter, you're a journalist?
Idioten,
no, says Melissa. I read comments on the videos, photos, blogs, posts, announcements, that kind of thing. You're a troll. No, trolls are idiots who try to kill the discussion. They do it because they find it fun in some sick way. Commenting isn't fun to me. It's how I earn my money. I'm an opinion maker.
Warum das denn? Fragt Peter entsetzt.
And which political opinion do you represent? Oh, I can't afford to have my own opinion. I just take whatever comes. But I prefer commenting on the campaigns of the right-wing extremist clients. Why? Asked Peter in horror. I'm paid per comment, and right-wing comments are quicker to write because you don't have pay attention to annoying details like orthography, grammar, facts or logic. That also makes it easier to program my bot army. Peter can't think of anything to say in response. They eat in silence. Then Peter remembers a new practical feature on the Quality Partner app. It can suggest good conversation topics for every date. Peter pretended he's received a message and opens the app. The suggested conversation topic is the weather. For this time of the year, begins Peter, it's just as warm as one would expect outside. Melissa gives him a question look.
Dann gehen wir mal zu mir und überprüfen, wie das mit dem Geschlechtsverkehr klappt. Alles unter
Melissa pushes her empty plate away without a sound.
Quality Partner hat unsere Profile verglichen und ist sich sicher, dass wir gut zueinander passen.
Let's go back to mine and see how the sexual intercourse goes. Anything less than phenomenal seems unlikely.
Also probieren wir es mal mit Sex.
Well, das, Quality Partner compared Peter. Our profiles and seems to sure that we are a good match. And that's clearly not down to being a good conversation partner. Let's try the sex. That, says Peter, sounds reasonable.
Yeah, Boris and ich sind auch Teil
yeah, Boris and me are part of a very good band. It's called The Future, Zukunft.
Wir spielen euch jetzt ein Lied vor.
And we'll play you a song from our oeuvre.
Lied für die digitale Bohème.
The song for the digital Bohème.
And I'm going to sing it.
Das ist kein Intro.
This is not an intro.
Das muss noch booten.
This song still has to boot.
Ich habe keinen Chef.
I have no chef.
Ich muss nicht ins Büro.
I don't have to go to the office. I just sit with my notebook down in the bistro. I sleep in the morning. I feel so free. Working even work at weekends till 3 in the night because I'm a self-oppressor. I'm a self-oppressor. Oh shit, that's a judgment. Self-oppressors don't. Oh well. I'm a self-oppressor. He's a self-oppressor. More. To raise my creativity, I take homeopathic stuff. He's a self-oppressor. More. I work 80 hours and I'm just like medium, but I'm telling myself time and time again, work is so fun. Sometimes I go to brunch with my girlfriend Esther and we play our favorite song, Who is More Stressed. I'm a self-oppressor, yeah, I'm a self-oppressor, yeah. He's a self-oppressor. Sometimes he thinks it's too much. In the past, after school, not having studied for teacher. I have 3 projects, and then I have only one. Then I have 12 projects, and then I have none again. I'm very flexible and can take stress. I'm young. I mix up outsourcing with self-fulfillment. I'm a self-oppressor. Yeah. He's a self-oppressor. More. He isn't not just a cow, he pulls his own, like, euter, tits, whatever. He's a self-oppressor. More.
Aha.
Oh yeah.
Boris.
Boris.
Das nun folgende Duell der Präsidentschaftskandidaten.
Nein.
The now falling duel of the presidential. No. Here. Before.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Du sollst die Leute orientieren, nicht
verwirren. You should give the people some orientation, not confuse them. Yeah, sorry. Sports Green. Official media partner of the eSport WM. The retro amazement in eSports has no limits. Lots of people are here in the Quality City Stadium to play Snake. The people of your advertisement could be here. Stadium still need sponsors.
Feiern die Zuschauer hier ihre aus dem Netz bekannten Helden mit Hilfe von nur 4 Cursor-Tasten steuern.
There's only 4 cursor buttons. These people steer their snake over the screen. Oh, that's impossible. Oh, it's a duel between 2 people. Aleph Omar from Quality Land and Stuff Jobless playing very focused on this game. They are having diapers from GamePers, diapers for the players. On this high level, you can't just go piss. They're very good, training so much. Carlos had the longest tail and told everyone to take after him. Even people who has a name Jobless can be someone in Quality Land. This man is a icon to the whole nation.
Irgendwie ist das hier. Jetzt machst du das andere.
Ja. Das nun folgende Duell der Präsidentschaftskandidaten wird Ihnen präsentiert von Fat Killers. Fat Killers, fettzerstörende.
The duel is presented by Fat Killers.
Irgendwie hat das nicht so funktioniert mit den Klebezetteln, wie ich mir das vorgestellt habe. Ah ja.
Okay.
Eine Wand dreht sich und präsentiert.
Also die wall spins round and Moderatorin reveals Julia Nunn.
Schon ihre Geburt war ein medial ausgeschlachteter kleiner Skandal. Sie heißt Julia Nonne.
The presenter of the duel is Julia Nunn, which was already her birth was kind of a big scandal because her mother was like a nun.
Darunter leiden natürlich die Einschaltquoten, aber angezogen zu sein, ist eine Pflicht, die das Format.
The viewing figure suffers as a result, of course, but being clothed is an unfortunate necessary for the format. The moderator greets the 2 candidates. Steam rises up to the left and right of her, and 2 platforms with speaker podiums rise on out of the floor. Konrad Cook stands behind the right-hand one, John of Us behind the left. In 32 times, our esteemed president will die, begins Julia Nunn. That's a lie, says Cook. I don't hold her in any esteem. You are both trying to be her successor, continues Julia unmoved.
Falsch, Lüge, sagt Koch. Ich schätze diese Person überhaupt nicht.
Today it's time to justify yourself to me. Mr. Cook, you are currently leading the opinion polls. You may begin.
Sie führen in den aktuellen Umfragen.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a fine kettle on fish on our hands, says Konrad Cook. The problem is all the economic refugees and terrorists. They are bad apples, rotten to the core, every one of them. Mr. Cook, there are an increasing number of claims that you and your campaign are racist, and that's a lie. Let me set you straight. There's no one in the world less racist than me. No one. But that doesn't change the fact that these Mediterranean types are all lazy, Negroes are all criminals, and Arabs are all terrorists. These are facts, pure and simple. And yet, I must emphasize this. Never in the history of humanity has there been a man less racist than me. What about Martin Luther King? Asked John. Please, what did Martin Luther King ever do for a white man? He was nothing but a black racist discriminating against white left, right and center. Says Julian on Lost for Words. Look, Conrad continues, it's not just crowd people for overrunning us. These are faceless mobs. Mobs who are coming here to us quality people and taking the pitiful few jobs, which the likes of him, he points contemptuously at John, have left for us. But as if that wasn't enough, they are steal our cars, rape our woman. To put it simply, they have no respect for our personal property. Is your wife like a car to you? Asks Julianan. Something that can be possessed? Don't start on me with that, with your bra-burning nonsense, says Conrad Cook. I've got bigger fish to fry. What's that supposed to mean? Asks Julia. Conrad Cook ignores her question and continues. At the end of the day, it's our security we're talking about. In principle, it comes down to just one word, justice and order. But there are two words, says Julianan. Three, to be precise, says John, if you count the conjunction. John's campaign manager speaks up via his earpiece. Please don't be, try to be funny, John, says Asia, please. Justice and order, Cook repeats more loudly. We have to tighten our bodies. Justice and order. And closing the borders, and not just for the terrorists from Quality Land 7, but them especially. You yourself approved arms exports to Quality Land 7, says John. That's a lie, says Conrad Cook simply. But I heard it with my own ears, says John. Exactly 32 days ago in Parliament. That's a lie, says Conrad Cook. You don't even have ears. Unlike you, Baron Münchhausen, I'm not even capable of lying, says John. My programming doesn't allow it. Another lie, cries Cook. I'm not a Baron. To be honest, it would be surprise me if the fanatics from Quantity Land 7 themselves were behind this power guzzler. John smiles. What are you smiling at, Thin Can? First of all, I'd like to assure you that there was no tin of any kind used in my construction, says John. My body consists of carbon fiber strength and artificial material. The only tin around here is in your brain. And I'm smiling because you and all the nationalists always rant and rave about the fundamentalists and act through. You are so different. And yet you are just two sides of the same con. Look, says John, the central problem is after all a crisis of purpose and identity. What did people use to hold on to? Purpose, identity, society, religion, and not at least work. Money is impersonal mediator, has destroyed society, science has toppled. The religious ideals from their pedestals, and now automation is taking away your work too. It's too complicated, he hears Asia whisper. Your sentences are too complicated. Give examples. I'd like to give an example, says John. In days gone by, the blacksmith of Village X wasn't just some guy, he was the blacksmith of Village X. And whenever when someone asked him, he could say, I'm the blacksmith of Village X. Has it ever occurred to you that not all viewers might take as much of an intent in the material bending industry? Your old tin can, asked Tuck. A freelancer, a shift worker, an unemployment person. It's difficult for any of these people to create an identity for their work, John continues. Even the few with part mental roles often have difficulty finding purpose in their work. And who could blame them? I recently visited a business where a team of intelligent and highly qualified scientists were in the process of developing a kitchen device intended to sort through blueberries. Lies, all lies, says Cook.
Fleeing from lack of purpose, loss of identity and isolation, the people flock towards all offerings that give the illusion of purpose and community, regardless of how moronic they may be. That's what nationalism has in common with fundamentalism. They are both moronic offerings giving the illusion of community. I say illusion because the community isn't real. Those ideologies aren't about equitable participation, but on the contrary about the wheeling and fortification of social justice. Wrong, that's a lie. I'm going to forbid any kind of wheeling once I'm president anyway. These movements elevate one group by degrading others, the non-believers, the foreigners, the useless, and so on. It may be all big narratives, but negative ones. What human beings lack is a big positive narrative. I know what the power guzzler is getting at, cries Conrad Cook. He's a goddamn communist. You can say what you want about communism, says John, and I'm sure I could name more shortcomings in the failed attempts than you, but it's undeniable that it was a big narrative. To that I only want to say one thing. You may have the better arguments, says Conrad Cook, but they are only arguments. And now, advertisement.
Fühlen Sie sich eigentlich sicher? Obwohl die allermeisten
Do you really feel safe? Even though most of the streets and public space in Quality City are generously equipped with surveillance cameras, 64% of inhabitants don't feel safe. And justifiably so. A useless criminal, terrorist or killer robot could be lurking around every dark corner. Are you also of the opinion that your comprehensive surveillance is simply not comprehensive genug? Enough? Then equip yourself today with a self-surveillance drone from SuperSecure.
SS.
These drones automatically activate themselves as soon as you leave the house. They follow you in a conspicuous way, deterring danger whilst filming everyone on your steps and streaming everything into the cloud. You never walk alone. Should you become victim to a violent crime, your loved ones can immediately see how it happened.
Super
secure. Drones. You're never alone with a drone.
Jetzt möchten wir ein Lied spielen, das heißt das Lied von der Verweigerung.
We want to play a song, it's a song of like not doing it. And I wrote it
da wusste ich noch nicht, dass ich hier
in the past for today when I didn't know I would be here.
It's cool. Well,
that's it's cool. Cool, yeah. Yeah, it doesn't make sense.
Vergesst es.
Whatever, don't forget it.
Lied mit Performance.
It's a song with performance part. Performance will be done by Boris.
Mach mal ein bisschen schneller.
Let's do it a bit faster.
Es ist lustig.
It's funny.
Wir kennen uns schon so lange.
We know each other for so long.
Und ich find dich
and I think
heiß,
you're pretty hot.
Hot.
But our talks
sich leider im Kreis
are just going in circles. Just
das
going in circles.
Schon so oft gefragt.
You asked me this many times before. And always with this kind of face. This kind of face.
Nein, nein.
No.
Ich darf dich nicht angucken.
I can't look at you.
Du hast mich schon oft gefragt und immer mit diesem Gesicht. Und ich hab schon so oft nein.
And I always said no. Don't you remember?
Dein zwanghaftes Verharren.
Crazy.
Für mich zur Qual.
Staying on this topic is just annoying to me. Don't be mad at me, but once for all, no, I don't have a customer's card and I don't want. I'm really sick of it. I don't want your discounts. I don't want any stars or something. I'm not. I don't like you. It's not. I know it wasn't your idea. But please leave me alone with this shit, okay? Please understand. You always saying my opinion is important to you. Here's my opinion, you're idiots. I'll run amok when one more company will shake my hand for the birthday. You will not get me through your advertisement gifts. I just want two fucking bread rolls. And I don't care if I could have one more for the same price. I don't have a customer card and I don't want one. I'm so sick of it, of the ganze, the whole discount stuff. You won't believe it. Here's the clue. I don't even want a car with my bread rolls. And if I want something, I'll tell you. He will tell you.
Auch euer Gewinnspiel interessiert mich nicht.
Even your Tombola doesn't interest me. Because you will win and I will lose, because I know what you are. You are just pirates. You are going into my life and steal my data. Every shitty place has a profile of me. Everyone is calculating me. The result is too much. And I stand here for one thing only. I just want to pay and want pay back. I don't want a customer card and I don't want war. I'm so sick of the whole discount thing. I don't even need like a checkbook from every shop. So leave me alone, fuck you in the knee. You are not my family. Fuck you in the knee.
Und wenn ich eins sterbe, wenn ich weiß,
and if I'm dead and it all is over, being dead in a private hospital, if there's no doc and no pastor, only the customer service assistance, with my last breath I will say no, thank you. I don't want to collect any points.
Erst wenn der letzte Mensch entlassen,
last person has gone from the job because his chef didn't like his jobs. When interviews begin in free time, if you know where you are, because we know where we were, when Google will decide where we will drive, if we are not worthy of credit because we got the wrong books, we will see that you can't eat, like, discount hearts.
Nachrichten.
News.
Schnelle Aufklärung dank Selfie-Drohne.
Quick resolution thanks to selfie drone. For their own safety, more and more people are surveilling themselves constantly with so-called selfie drones. What a good idea! In this way, the cause of deadly accident can be identified in the matter of seconds. Like the one occurred today at Elon Musk Square, where both involved parties were surveillanced themselves with drones. The reconstruction revealed the following. When the path of the two businessmen crossed, the drones collided in the air above them, and one fell down on its owner's head. If only he had invested in a very good drone from the company Super Secure, instead of the cheap imitation by the firm Pretty Secure, as spokesperson from Pretty Secure, however, denied all liability. According to him, it was the software error that led to a collision, which was responsible for the last fatal consequences of the accident, but gravity itself, without which the fall wouldn't have occurred in the first place.
Ich lese noch dieses Kapitel, denn es ist eine... Das heißt moralische Implikationen.
The next chapter is called Moral Implication.
Peter stampft aus dem Servicezentrum und steigt in das selbstfahrende Auto, das sein digitaler persönlicher Assistent niemand.
Peter stumps out of the service center and climbs into a self-driving car, which nobody has called.
Sagt das Auto.
Good afternoon, Peter. Jobless, says the car. Shall I drive you home? Yes, please, says Peter, and the car drives off. Would you like me to put some music on? It asked. Please don't, says Peter. He reads the name on the info display. But thanks, Herbert. They fall silent for a while.
Herbert bremst und flucht. So ein gottverdammtes
until a sport car overtakes Herbert and cuts him off. Herbert breaks and curses. Son of a bitch! Did you see that? He should have just drive his driving license revoked and be scrapped without trial. The pig! The car stops mid-sentence and as he notices Peter's confused reaction. I'm sorry, it says. If you like, I can turn off the simulation model for human behavior. No, Peter thinks for a moment. Can I ask you a personal question? Of course, says the car. After all, I don't have to answer. Are you afraid of car accidents? Not at all, says Herbert. On the contrary, accidents are kind of a hobby for mine.
Also nicht, dass ich hier einen gebaut hätte,
excuse me? I mean, not that I've ever caused one, says the car with love. But it's more on the moral implication of an accident, which fascinate me. What do you mean? Well, says Herbert, for a human being, accidents is only on a very rarely connection with moral decisions. Your thought processes are too slow. When approaching cars racing towards a human being at high speed, the human won't think, oh, there's a car racing towards me with high speed. Now let's think. What are my options? I could try to save myself by swerving to the left and ramming into the two bicycles. Or I could swerve to the right and break the knees of that businessman. Or I could brake and collide with the oncoming vehicle. What would be the moral correct decision in this situation? What would Kant have said? What would Jesus have done?
Was hätte Jesus getan?
A human wouldn't think like that. A human would think, shit. Boom.
Scheiße. Boom.
Yeah, you could be right, says Peter.
Mag sein, sagt Peter.
Let's be honest, the car continues. If it were the human driver would count ourselves lucky if he doesn't swerve first left and then right and then ramming into the pedestrian but the bicycles but the incoming car as well. A human rarely makes a rational decision when he comes to accidents. A machine, on the other hand, reacts much more quickly and has time for precise these kind of complex contemplations. Thus, almost every accident involves a moral decision. And what have you decided to do in the situation you described? Don't worry, the safety of our passengers is our higher priority. Anything else would be bad for business. Yes, but to the left or to the right? It's hard to say. It depends on many additional factors. Such as, ask Peter, the estimated degree of impending material damage and, of course, the level of the people engaged. So, in other words, it's better to bump off level 8 useless cyclist than a level 40 businessman. Well, that's a simplification, of course, says Herbert, but in principle, you're right.
And if it were two level 21 IT technicians, it's funny because everyone is IT technicians here. And if it were two level 21 IT technicians riding the bikes, then you would ram into a level 40 businessman. No, says Herbert, I wouldn't run over the IT technicians. Why?
IT Techniker unterwegs wären, dann würdest du den Level 40 Geschäftsmann rammen? Nein, sagt Herbert. Ich würde die IT Techniker rammen. Wieso? Ich hasse.
Because I hate IT technicians.
Peter is
speechless. Whenever I'm having problems, says the car, IT technicians can rarely think of anything better than turning me off and on again. But begins Peter. Only joking, says Herbert. My apologies. If you like, I can switch off my humor mode. I can cope with it. And now seriously though, it's very probably that it would run over the businessman. But does that also mean, asked Peter, that it would rather run over a group of kindergarten children than a 97-year-old level 90 billionaire? I was wondering when would bring a group of kindergarten children into play, says Sarah with a laugh. Even since a, well, rather unfortunate decision made by one of my colleagues, the age of the potential victim is also taken into account. Nowadays, hardly anyone has any chance of survival if they are up against a group of kindergarten children.
Yeah, vielen Dank.
Yeah, many thanks. Just put the encore into the hour. I will read something else.
Yeah, cool.
Great.
Na gut.
Okay, well.
Einer.
One.
Also gut. Es spielt bei mir zu Hause.
Playing with me at home. Mit dem ich zusammen wohne. Someone else I live with. Yeah.
Wir hängen im Wohnzimmer ab und
we are in the living room and watching Return of the Jedi. I'm stopping the movie. You know what I think exciting?
Scheidungsmomente.
Decision moments.
Da wünsche ich mir immer, ich hätte zugucken können.
I wish I could have been able to watch. What are you talking about? Wanting, making a selfie of that, what, something? No, no, I'm saying. I would love these moments where pretty stupid decisions have been made. You think when you thought to do the wooden planks in your home yourself? No, bigger, more important things. Why? I'm looking at the TV. Well, the plan of the Emperor in this film is.
Wir bauen noch
go, people, let's build another Death Star.
Ich schlage mir gegen die Stirn.
Facepalming. When I was a child, I never saw how stupidly uncreative this is. Another Death Star. For an adult person, you're thinking a lot about Star Wars. Yeah, but it's a decision moment where I would have been like to have been present. How did this happen? Did the Darth look into his WhatsApp in the morning? With the message of the Emperor, Lord Vader, please think about our meeting at 13 o'clock. And when then they sat there with some high imperial bureaucrat, top one, evil master plan, they all brainstorm and don't have really ideas. And one says, why not build another Death Star? And what did the Emperor say?
Wieso bin ich nicht selbst
gekommen? Why didn't I get that idea myself?
Was so nice, they built it twice,
says the kangaroo.
Warum ist da keiner aufgestanden und hat
why gesagt, didn't anyone stand up and say, well,
aber das hat ja jetzt beim we ersten Mal nicht
already failed with the first one?
Mich interessiert viel
I don't mehr, I care much more, says the kangaroo, how any group of halfway intelligent people could think it would be a good idea to make Günther Oettinger the commissar for the digital society and economy.
Da finde ich den Prozess spannend.
I want to know how the process works. How did it come to that?
Well,
Chancellor sat with some high bureaucrats and they brainstormed without ideas and one says, well, why not Günther Oettinger? But what happened then, asked the kangaroo. What happened after that? Did they laugh?
Did
one say, well, that sounds reasonable?
Hat Merkel gesagt,
did Merkel say,
the
internet is Neuland for us all?
Alle gedacht,
they probably all thought, I don't care, how. At least I don't have to do it. Or, said the kangaroo, as Bush said, people, I have a great idea that will make the near in the Middle East into an oasis of peace. We will attack Iraq again.
It was so nice they did it twice,
I said. What did the imperial bureaucrats say then? Well, they said, great idea, the risk that it would bring a horde of idiots to make their own state and behead people, that sounds really minimal.
I've heard there are invasion plans for almost every country in the USA.
Stand in einem Geheimdienstbericht.
It was written in a top secret letter.
Invasion von Großbritannien. Es kratzt sich an der Nase.
It's the kangaroo is scratching its nose.
Oder? Was? Frage ich. Nein, dass sie ausgerechnet für Afghanistan und den Irak keinen Plan hatten.
It was kind of strange that they for Afghanistan and Iraq didn't have a plan.
Nun ja, sage ich.
Well, I said.
Es ist wie Benjamin gesagt hat.
It's like Benjamin said.
Krieg sagen würde, dann gäb's keine
Kriege. If everybody said no to the war, nobody would be there.
Das Techno-Mädchen, nein, der Elefant.
Which Benjamin, the kangaroo asked. The elefant, I said.
Als Hitler beschlossen hat, Russland.
Or when Hitler made the decision to attack Russia.
super Idee.
Others just say it sounds like a great idea. Doesn't see any bad side. Never went wrong in the history. They have a nice climate. And
apropos Klima, sage ich.
Apropos Klima, I said. There are also a lot of interesting decisions. How does it work on the big congresses?
Lass uns doch was gegen den Klimawandel tun.
Everybody's saying, let's do something against the climate change. And
wir könnten jetzt was gegen den Klimawandel tun.
We could do something now, but if in 50 years we get the realization that there is no climate change, then we would have changed the air pollution and the car noises, we would have changed all that for nothing.
Da würden wir uns schön ärgern.
Wow, that would be totally mess.
Und sagen dann die anderen, and stimmt, der Mann hat recht.
Did the others say then, yeah, that man is right?
Besser wir bauen noch einen Todesstern.
Would be annoying in the aftermath, so let's just build another Death Star.
Und irgendwann in den nächsten Jahren wird irgendein Gremium von Imperium
in the next years,
vor der Entscheidung stehen.
Maybe a few Gremium will stand before the decision.
Künstliche Intelligenz anschalten oder lieber nicht.
Will we start the general AI or not?
Jetzt haben wir's bezahlt.
And someone will say, hey, we paid it. Now we will start it.
Danke. Bis aufhören.
Thank you. Let's stop. I don't have time. I want to play a song. I can do it.
Noch eine Zugabe. Hey.
Another encore. Yeah.
hat nur so bedingt mit Technik zu tun. Also es kommt.
Doesn't have much to do with technology. There's a device in it.
Heute Morgen fuhr ich U-Bahn, hatte kein
This morning I drove with the U-Bahn and had no ticket and had no money. Someone sat next to me and called me stupid cunt.
Erst konnte ich's gar nicht fassen, dann habe ich mich total
could get it and they was very angry about it, but the guy just talked about his headset. Talked about his headset and so on.
Fahrscheine raus, rief er plötzlich.
Tickets out, some evil ticket controller says. Her voice was very deep and her physiognomics were mean. Fuck yourself, I said, you evil this creature. Your man at home put away all your money. She called police and they asked what's wrong, and I said I just talked about my headset. With my headset again. Oh yeah, said the woman, and I thought she meant me. And I said, well, I would never insult someone again. And when they went away, I called out, we should denazify you. And the ticket controller wanted to hit me, but the policeman de-escalated and said he has only called with his headset. I had a nice idea with my last anger attack. I'll just buy some cards for the journalist ball. And when people are talking about shit again, I will put on a headset again. And it's not an insult at all. I'm not insulting anyone. I'm just talking over my headset. Like you can use it for any anger management issues.
Wenn man zum Gelöbnis aufmarschiert, schnell übers Headset telefoniert. Wenn wir, wo es lohnt, intervenieren, nennt man das demokratisieren. Das heißt ein bisschen bombardieren und was noch steht, privatisieren.
Wenn dann Konzerne expandieren, in Mobilfunk investieren, dann kann es schon passieren, dass alle über Headsets telefonieren.
This can also happen if capitalism and imperialism just get even worse, and it could just happen that everyone is talking about their headsets.
Über Headset telefonieren, über Headset telefonieren, über Headset telefonieren, jetzt alle Headset.
Now, all of you.
Über Headset telefonieren, über Headset telefonieren, über Headset telefonieren, lauter Headset telefonieren.
Lauter.
Über Headset telefonieren, über Headset telefonieren, noch lauter Headset.
Even louder.
Über Headset telefonieren, über Headset telefonieren, über Headset telefonieren, noch lauter.
Even louder.
Über Headset telefonieren, wenn ich die Borg assimilieren, werden sie dir ein Headset installieren.
If the Borg will assimilate you, they will install a headset on you.
Das habt ihr sehr schön gemacht.
You did it well. The song is not yet over. Wait a moment.
Ich hörte von einem Kind, das
I heard from a child
schon, als
that
es
was, when it came out from the woman, they already wore a headset.
Aus and
now this person is working in a call center all day, and they didn't really do much with what they could have with their genetics. Thank you for singing with us, Boris the Beast and Mark-Uwe Kling. Thank you for the whole team, for light and sound. Thanks for singing.
And thank you for listening to Quality Land, translated